My name is Matt, and I'm a support engineer at Agilent Technologies. Today we'd like to talk about the differences between the N6705A mainframe and the new N6705B mainframe. You can see by looking at the front panels here that they're very similar looking, but there's a few key differences, and we'd like to highlight those for you. The first thing we'd like to talk about are the modules that each unit supports. So the B mainframe supports all the same modules as the A mainframe. In addition, the B mainframe will also be able to support the N6753A 20 volt, 50 amp, 300 watt module. Both mainframes can support the new N6780 SMU modules that are coming out. Specs for all these modules will be available on Agilent's website at agilent.com in the product manuals. Now let's take a closer look at the front panel of the B mainframe. So here's a closer look at the front panel of the B mainframe. The first thing on the front panel we want to talk about is the assembly behind the bonding post here. We lowered the capacitance in order to handle the faster transient and higher programming measurement accuracy for the new N6780 SMU modules. And again, all the specifications for the modules will be in their manuals on the website at agilent.com. The other thing we changed was the graphic overlay that labels all of our keys and knobs. If you look at some of the knobs, they have a secondary function if you press on them. We're just going to highlight the trigger level one here. So when you turn the trigger level knob, it'll change the trigger level in scope and data logger modes. But if you press on it, it'll execute an auto scale in data logger and scope modes. And you can see the graphic represents that. So it says trigger level, which is the main function, and then auto scale if you press the knob. So next we're going to take a look at the differences on the rear panels of the units. Here are the rear panels of the two instruments. The A is on the bottom and the B is on top. You can see that they're similar, just like the front panel, but the B has some more openings and a few more connections than the A does. We're going to take a closer look at the rear panel of the B and highlight these differences for you. So here's the rear panel of the B mainframe. You can see that it has the external trigger input and output BSC connectors like the A, the 8-pin digital port, the USB, LAN, and GPIB connection ports. You can also see that there's these openings on the top and bottom and a new connector on the top and bottom. So the openings are so that you can run wire from the module out the rear of the unit. And this is useful for rack mounting. If you have it in a rack, you don't want wires going around to the front. It's also imperative that you use these openings for the N6753A module. The front panel bonding posts are not rated to do 50 amperes, so to do 50 amperes, you have to use these rear openings. There's also these two connectors here for the auxiliary voltage measurement on the N6781A module. So on the inside, you plug the connector in, and then that'll break those out to the rear panel so that you can access them with the covers on. And all these connectors, the 8-pin connectors you need, are included with the mainframe in the box when it ships. Now we're going to take the top covers off of both units and take a look at the connector scheme for connecting the modules up. Here's the A mainframe with the top cover off. So this is the area that the modules sit in when you install them into the frame. The one thing we want to point out is the way you connect modules with the A mainframe is via this wiring harness that's actually split into two. You have one connector for the 10 amp modules and a separate connector for the 12 amp and higher modules. And these connectors are actually crimped on, so you can't take them off or put the new connector for the N6780 SMU modules on it. In order to connect the N6780 module into this, you need to use a connector adapter that we provide with each unit. And there'll be a separate video showing you how to install one of those modules in this mainframe. So now let's take a similar look at the same area on the B mainframe. So here's the top of the B mainframe where you connect the module. You can see it's pretty different than the A. So the first thing we're going to point out is this RFI strip here that connects the modules to the chassis a bit better. The other thing that changed quite drastically is the way we connect up to modules. So now, instead of having the crimped-on connectors and the split wire with the two connectors on it, we have one wire that you put the connector on yourself. So you need to take the connector that came with the module when you purchased it and install it onto the wires here. And the wires are all color-coded, and the key to the color coding is located on the label right there. So you just match that up to the label on the rear of the module, and it shouldn't be much trouble at all putting the connector on. You see here's one with the connector on in channel 1. The other thing we have are these connectors that connect to the auxiliary measurement on the N6781A module that take that port out to the back rear panel of the unit that we showed earlier. So we've highlighted some differences between the A mainframe and the B mainframe. Differences on the front panel, in the top where the modules connect, and on the rear panel. If you have any questions about either of these products or any Agilent products, please contact us at Agilent's website at agilent.com. Thanks for watching. This is Matt. Bye.